Hey everyone, thanks for clicking another video of Let's Roll Outdoors. Here's the deal. We're going to go hunting in the Hawaii Highlands and get us a pig, all right? Nice boar with the archery gear. So that's what you're going to see. I'm going to just come right out front and tell you that's what's on this video. All right, if you're a subscriber, hey, I'm sorry I've taken so long to post new videos. I'm busy, all right? I'm busy, and this is just a hobby. So, hey, thanks for sticking around, staying a subscriber, and waiting for my next video to hit. For those of you who don't subscribe, hey, check it out. This is what I do. I'm just a normal average dude that likes hunting and fishing and going out with my family and getting outdoors. And I make little videos, make little vlogs, little video blogs, and I post them here on YouTube to share with all of you. And hopefully you can get something out of them. I try to put some information in there, try to make them kind of entertaining. And that's what we got going on today. A little entertaining Hawaii hog blog edition with some archery gear and some good action. All right, so thanks for clicking another video, and that's enough of me talking. Let's start watching this video. Thanks.
Hey everyone, welcome to another video. I'm out here in my little spot that I've got baited. Got my Aloha shirt back on, and we're trying to shoot a pig. All right, we had some good luck with the Aloha shirt last time. I got to see some pigs, but no shots. And so I figured I'd try it on again. I'm gonna keep wearing this shirt until we get a pig wearing this my Aloha gear, all right? So I'm gonna turn the camera around. You can see where we're hunting. This is a spot that I've made a couple videos with now. I've baited it up, saw some pigs here the other day, and now we're waiting. All right. Right in that hole down there, down in the bottom. It's where I've baited up for the past couple days. And I know they're eating it, because it's always gone. And we're just gonna try to get some meat. Any pig that comes out today, I'll try to get a shot and get some meat. Let's see what happens. Big boar. Nice boar. I just hit a big boar. Big boar. All right, folks, here's what just happened. Had a nice boar sneak right in on me. I don't know, 15 yards, if that. I forgot to push record on the GoPro. So you got me draw back and shoot, but of course, that's hunting by yourself. And hey, it's just fun making videos out here hunting. We're gonna give this pig, I don't know, a good 30, 45 minutes, and then see if we can start looking for him. I don't know. Dark tree that kind of curves over, bends over like that, right in the middle. The pig was right under that tree, maybe 15 yards. And looks like I stuck him right behind the elbow, but the arrow was still sticking out of him when he ran off, so I don't know how much penetration I got there. They're tough. They got a lot of thick skin to get through if I hit him too high. He was right there, though. Initial look is pretty good blood right here on impact. So as long as that blood trail continues, we should do all right. Alright, so here's that blood that I was just filming, and he kind of continues on up the hill. And because of the size that he is, and I saw the arrow still sticking out of him, I'm not going to push him. I'm going to wait for about 45 minutes at least before I continue. But I just wanted to make sure I found the spot where I hit him, see if I found blood. I got blood. I'm just going to be patient and try to relax and not try to push him. What you don't want to do is keep pushing him and scare him. And then you'll never find him, which I've you know, accidentally done before. Also with pigs, especially a big boar, if they're still alive, they might charge you, you know, if they feel threatened. So you want to go ahead and give them plenty of time to lay down and expire, and that's what we're going to do here tonight. All right, I'm still anxious, so I'm going to keep talking to you. You're the only company I have here right now in the woods, all by myself. You, me, and the birds. I'm going to show you some of this blood splatter real quick. Right here, about, I don't know, 3 or 4 yards from impact, but I think this is going to be a good blood trail. Check this out. Blood on this stick, blood on the tree, splattered. It's spraying out, so that's a good sign. There's blood all down here on the grass, blood here on the grass. And it just continues, splattered all the way up there. So I think as long as we give this guy time to expire, lay down and expire, we might be all right. We might have us a nice pig here this evening. All right. Here comes another one right to us. I'm waiting to go blood trail that other one. Here comes a nice little shooter size young boar. I saw that one the other day with my kids. I'm just standing here waiting to go blood trail the one we just shot. Been waiting for about an hour, and then that one just came into my bait site down there. Might have to come back and get him later. Okay, folks, it's been about an hour. Just had that little boar come in behind us there. We're not interested in filming little boars. We're interested in finding the pig that I shot. So it's been about an hour. Let's check out this blood trail. Okay, so the pig was standing right under that curved tree right there. And I have blood right at the point of impact, and it sprayed all over here. And it continued all here onto that tree, down on these leaves. And it just continues this way. So as long as the blood continues this way, we should be able to track them all right. Okay, just want to give you an update. If you're not used to blood trailing, okay, you can see it's not always just splattered blood everywhere, okay? Got some drops on the grass right there. And it's splattered up through this grass. And it's even up on this side. So maybe that tells me I've got two holes on each side of the body if I got blood coming out both ways like that. There's a trail that goes over there, and that could be misleading. Oh, I just want to follow the trail. But actually, the blood goes up through this grass. So that's where we're headed, up into this nasty stuff. Fun. Okay, so I know I'm on the right track because I just found my arrow right here. So you always want to go slow so you don't run into that guy right there. It's a muzzy broadhead, standard 3-blade muzzy broadhead what I'm using, and gold tip arrows, 400 grain gold tips, standard setup, okay? And I seem to get good penetration today. Got blood all up and down that arrow, so I don't know if it worked its way through or if it came out from the impact spot, but it's a lot of blood on there. All right, let's continue. And it just continues on right here. Plenty of blood right there. And this is where he's starting to get suspect and hope that he's down and not alive waiting for you up here somewhere. That's the excitement. The excitement of getting tore up by a pig. Here we go. Up this trail, folks. Yep. Yep, got good blood. Got good blood right up through here. We're also getting all hung up everywhere. But yes, good blood. Still continuing up through here. All right, so got some drops here. And it looks like a trail, but there's a lot of blood right here, but then kind of lose it. Oh, okay. Blood on the dirt right here. Oh, I smell. Oh, look at that. Man, I'm glad that sucker's dead. Woo, look at that. Got him, folks. Whew. Got him. Wow, perfect shot right there. All right, let's check him out. Let's pull him out here and check him out. All right. Hey, I'm just gonna get the moment in here. Real quick, after a after work hunt, threw on my Aloha Flage, and real quick, just ran out here to a spot I've been hunting, and man, look at that. Nice boar right there. Not a monster by any means, but definitely he's got some tusks. I got branches in my face, and there he is. Good lung shot. You see those bubbles coming out? That means I hit lungs. All right, got it done out here. We're gonna drag him out and get some good pictures of him. All right, woo! All right, we gotta figure out, I don't know, the easiest way. I'm gonna get him back out of here and go ahead and drag him out, all right? I don't mind doing the work. Put all the work into hunting and getting the animal. I don't mind doing the work to drag it out and clean it up and get some meat in the freezer. All right, just wanna keep it recording. I'm excited to share this. All right. The only thing that's missing now is I don't have my kids with me, any of my kids. And they've been hunting just as hard as I have, and I wish they could be here. But we're going to drag this sucker out here, get some pictures, and continue on. All right, let's roll. Okay. It's really not that far of a drag up to the open ground. It's just through this stuff. It's not exactly the easiest drag. So, making progress little by little. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap her up. Got the pig down here. I don't know if you can see it. It's dark. I got the light on me, but all right, we got some good action today on the Hawaii Hog Blog. I'm using a Tech Hunter Extreme bow from Gander Mountain. I've got gold tip arrows, warrior arrows, and muzzy broadheads. And hey, pig came out, went through both sides, hit both lungs, I think. And whatever, we got us a nice boar today, all right? So thanks for joining me. Keep clicking on our videos and I'll keep posting them, all right? All right, successful hunt. Successful hunt after work. That's where the arrow came through, right there. Good deal. Let's get out of here.